Now we come to the to how the density is related to the molar mass. Okay, so we come to the density and the molar mass. Density and the molar mass of a gaseous substance. Okay. Now we have this equation as the ideal gas equation. From the ideal gas equation, we have PV is equal to nRT, correct? So N is equal to PV upon RT. Okay. Now what is N? Fine. So if I convert it into mass and the molar mass, then what do I do to get the number of moles? N is equal to M upon M, is it not? Yes. So M is the mass of the gas and M is the molar mass, which is normally specified in grams, right? It is in grams. So in grams. And molar mass you have to have in grams. Then this works, correct? And N is equal to M upon M. This we know. Now, M upon V. So it is mass upon volume. We wanted to relate the density with the molar mass. So M upon V is equal to P upon RT into M. Okay. Now M upon V is density. So density is equal to P upon RT upon M. Now it gives you a very, very important conclusion, which is what? It tells you that density is directly proportional to the molar mass at the same pressure and temperature. So if you have so many gases at the same pressure and temperature, then the gas with the higher molar mass will have a higher density. Now that is something that is not so intuitive, right? It's not so intuitive. But somehow this tells you that, and that is the power of this simple equation. Okay, so the emphasis that I put in the beginning of it was due to this. I want you to understand that this equation, if you latch onto it and do some minor manipulations, you'll get whatever is asked in a question. Okay? We understand that. So I make that conclusion that at the same temperature and pressure, a gas with higher molar mass will have a higher density. No? It has a higher density. This equation is also, or it can be also used in this way, that if you know the density of the gas, so m is equal to dRT upon p, at a given temperature and pressure, if you know the density, then you will be able to guess the, not guess, to calculate the molar mass of the gas. Fine. Okay. Okay. So just by knowing the density of a gas, you are able to know what kind of gas it is. You get the point. And that's really, really an incredible amount of advantage. See, if you have a container whose actual mass you know in vacuum, okay, and you have a sensitive scale which tells you what is the mass currently, and it is holding, say, only one kind of gas, so you are able to know what is the density, just mass upon volume. If it's a cubical kind of thing or a cuboidal thing, it's very easy to measure the volume, right? You measure the volume, you know the mass, so you know the density, you know the density, you plug it in here. You know the temperature, you know the pressure. Okay, pressure measurement is not even a child's play. I'll say it is an infant's play. Okay? Yes, the moment you understand what an open tube manometer is, it is really so incredibly easy to measure it. So pressure measurement is easy, temperature measurement is easy. The open tube manometer can be made within less than 50 rupees. Okay. A thermometer is available for less than 100 rupees, right? Or maybe 200. So P, T, R I know, D I'll be able to measure. So immediately you'll be able to tell what kind of gas is there in this without going into any of the chemical properties of it. Think it that way. And it's really incredible. The more you appreciate, the more you understand. Right? It's really incredible that this small equation, the very, 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 very meek and harmless looking equation, has got such power. And it really has such power. Okay? So never underestimate its use. So whenever you are dealing with a gas, whatever complexity there is, this has to be followed. Okay? Fine? Okay.